Hi everybody, welcome to a super quick tutorial on the toast module from the KivyMD library. So basically a toast, if you don't know, is just like a little pop-up. Pretty much, so I'll click this button, I'll show you. It's a pop-up with a message. Basically what it's typically used for is showing a user that, like confirming that they've done an action. So maybe you have like a list of items and the user deletes one, then you would show a little like toast here, toast message that says you successfully deleted your item, okay? So that's what it's used for, and that's what it looks like, and it's super easy to implement. So let's look in the code. First off, in my project folder, I've copied over the KivyMD package, of course, and I have my two files, main.py and main.kv. Here's my main.py file. I've just created an app class, and I have this show pop-up function that I don't have anything defined in yet. This is where I'll make the toast message. And then in my KV code, all I have is just a button. And then when I click the button, I'll call the show pop-up function from my main app class. Okay, so let's go ahead and define what I want in the show pop-up function. To import the toast module, it's actually a toast, it's a function. It's not a class like some other like KivyMD widgets. Toast is just a function. So I'll say from KivyMD.toast, import toast. And now in my function here, all I have to say is toast. And then I pass it a string for the message that I want. So like, this is a toast message. All right. And now if I run my app and I click my button here, it says this is a toast message. And also note that if I make a really long message, so let me just like copy paste this a couple times. Toast will automatically create like a new line if your message is too long. So here you can see it doesn't overflow on the sides, and it's created a new line if the message is too long. Okay, so that's all there is to the toast function. It's really just two lines of code from kivymd.toast import toast, and then you use the toast function. So that's it for this tutorial. Hope that was helpful, and thanks for watching.